Today we gather to celebrate our closing school mass. When we began the school year back in August, we did so, placing ourselves and the year ahead in the hands of God. From that beginning, we have gone through many times and seasons that have brought us to this closing, a closing unlike any that we have ever experienced. Throughout this year, throughout all these times and seasons, we know that our God has been with us. And now, as we move through this challenging season, this season of uncertainty, our God continues to be by our side. Our God, a God of miracles, a God of hope, a God of healing, a God of unconditional love, of mercy, and of compassion. Our God is with us, and we know that our God will never leave us. We realize that although our lives are different, we continue to be blessed to be a part of BSM. We are so much more than a school. We truly are family, helping each other to grow in wisdom, in grace, and in faith. For together or apart, we are Benilde-St. Margaret's. So as we begin, I simply ask that you join with us in prayer and in song, helping to make this a meaningful time for everyone. Now I invite you to join together in our alma mater.
Yes, and you teach us compassion, truth, and knowledge. Make us servants, leaders, to tend the poor and fallen. The Spirit fills your hallways with glory of the night. May you always keep us walking in the light. May we all walk proudly forever, then and
one. Wherever you gather today for this closing mass, it is your home. And it is with those who you call family and friends. But remember, we gather here to remember the home that we have at Benilde-St. Margaret's. And as Mr. Jay said, a place where we are family. And so as a family of God, let us pray together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. For the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the friendship of the Spirit is with all of you. As always, we gather on our closing mass to remember. So I'd like to invite us as our opening prayer to remember those that have been part of our circle of friends, those that we have known for a long time, those that we have just met this year. So let's just take a moment to be mindful of those that we call friends from this year at BSM. Let us pray. God of all gifts, we praise you, the source of all we have and are. Teach us to acknowledge always the many good things that your infinite love has given us. Help us to love you with all our heart and all our strength. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And now let us listen to our scripture that speaks of who we are and what it is that we have to give and share.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love. Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. The word of the Lord.
Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Cry out in joy to the Lord, all peoples on earth. Sing to the praise of God's name, proclaiming forever. Tremendous the deeds for us. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Leading your people safe through fire and water, bringing their souls to life. We sing of your glory. Your love is eternal. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord.
Glory to God who does wondrous things. Let all the people God's praises now sing. All of creation in splendor shall ring. Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
My friends, the Lord is with all of you. Our reading is from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As God loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept God's commandments and remain in God's love. I have told you this, so that my joy may be in you and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what their master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from God. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask God in my name, God may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord. We have lived with COVID-19 for almost 2 months. We know that it is contagious, infectious, and it's passed from one person to another. We are told to practice ways to stay safe and healthy and not pass it on. Wash your hands frequently. Do social distancing. Cover your cough or your sneeze. and stay home if you are sick. However, there is a vaccine. However, the vaccine is not the vaccine that has yet been discovered for COVID-19. But it is a vaccine that is very powerful. It's infectious. It is passed from one person to another. And that vaccine is what our scripture of today speaks about, what Jesus asks of us. It is a vaccine of love, to love one another. We all have it. You have it. I have it. We have that vaccine. And we have passed it on from one person to another. You have since the beginning of the school year. In our opening school mass, I invite us to live out our scripture theme. Let us then pursue what leads to peace and to build up one another. You have encouraged others. You have built them up in many ways. One through our common basket, the treehouse, Catholic relief services, Toys for Tots, Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. You've also done it in other ways. Welcomed a new student, been with the one who struggled, supported the one through your listening. This is what your love has done. This is what you have done. With COVID-19, we are told, wash your hands. In loving one another, we wash away that which can be harmful to others and to ourselves. We create a clean heart of love, a heart of hope, a heart of reaching out. We've been asked to social distance so that we don't infect others. We do want to be close. We do want to hug. We do want to hold hands, yet we aren't able for fear that it is not good, that there's a power in that which could bring harm. But there's also a power that we have to do good. And this is a power in our love, the power to send a positive message of appreciation, of thank you, the power to impact someone's life by the good we bring. God is love. God is in every act of love. As Christians, we remind ourselves that every act of love highlights God in the world. Because love is not just an idea. Love is something alive, living, personal, and true. The creating and nourishing power within life. At the beginning of the year, we had no idea how our scripture theme would play out as it has during this year. As the gospel says, Jesus has chosen each of us to share the vaccine of love, and that you have done. I'd like to end with one of our most enjoyed and loved songs. I won't be singing it, and I won't sing it in harmony with Mr. J. So I'm going to read it to you. And what I'd like to invite you to do is that after this liturgy, go to YouTube and pull it up. It's Lean On Me. And what I'm going to ask you to do is just what we do every time we sing this song in the Great Hall. Put it on, sing with it, and hopefully you're with people that you are safe with and their families. Put your arms around each other and sway back and forth, just as we always do here in the Great Hall when we sing that song. And remember this. This song is about both the God we lean on and about those who here at BSM who we lean on. Sometimes in our life, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, We know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm going to need someone to lean on. Please swallow your pride, if I have things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs that you won't let show. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need someone to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need someone to lean on. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need someone to lean on. You just call me brother, but you need a hand. We all need someone to lean on. For our prayers of the faithful, I'll ask you to do what I invited you to do for our Easter Mass, and that is, in a moment, to just take a moment to share your prayers with those who you have gathered with. Remember all of those who need our prayer, who need your prayer. But remember that always at this particular Mass, we blessed many, many people. And I'd ask you to include in your prayer those who will not be with us next year. They may be moving, may be changing schools, may be graduating. Pray, remember them. Faculty and staff that may be leaving BSM for other work, other opportunities, or to retire. Include them in your prayer. Let's all take a moment to do that prayer.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. As we pray this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is with all of you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Loving God, we are glad to give you thanks and praise because you love us. Because you love us, you gave us this great and beautiful world. Because you love us, you sent Jesus, your Son, to bring us to you and to gather us around him as people of one family. With such great love, we thank you with the angels and the saints as they praise you, and together we say, blessed be Jesus, whom you sent to be the friend of children of the poor. He came to show us how we can love you, Father, by loving one another. He came to take away sin, which keeps us from being friends, and hate, which separates us from one another. He promised to send the Holy Spirit to be with us always so that we can live as your children. God, we now ask you to send your Holy Spirit to change these gifts of bread and wine into the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord. The night before he died, Jesus, your Son, showed us how much you love us. When he was at supper with his disciples, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. Then he broke the bread, gave it to his friends, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, Jesus took the cup that was filled with wine. He thanked you, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. And so, loving God, we remember that Jesus died and rose again to save the world. He put himself into our hands to be the sacrifice we offer you. Lord of God, listen to our prayer. Send the Holy Spirit to all of us who share in this meal. May this Spirit bring us closer together in the family of the Church, with Francis our Pope, Bernard our Bishop, all other bishops, and all who serve your people. Remember, God, our families and friends, and all those we do not love as we should. Remember those who have died. Bring them home to be with you forever. Gather us all together into your kingdom. There we shall be happy forever, with the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and our Mother, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse. There all the friends of Jesus the Lord will sing a song of joy. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. With the confidence that we have of the God that we know that is always with us through all things, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but upon the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord is with you always. And let us take a moment in a way that we are able to share the peace of Christ with those who are with us as we have gathered to pray. We pray together. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. My friends, behold the Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, who invites us to love one another. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Although we have been unable to receive communion during these days, we can participate in the Eucharist through spiritual communion. I invite you to quiet yourselves and let these words sink into your heart as we pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as being already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. God, in this spiritual food, you have given from this table to us what we offer to you in thanksgiving, the saving sacrament of Christ your Son. By these gifts of strength and joy, sustain us in your service and bring us to your gift of eternal life. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is with all of you. And Almighty God blesses us, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Mass is never ended. It must be lived. Let us go forth to love and serve the Lord and one another. Alleluia, alleluia.
I no longer speak of you as slaves, for a slave does not know what their master is doing. Instead, I call you friends. In the fertile soil of you, can't believe the hopes he's granted, means a chapter in your life is through, but we'll keep you close as always. It won't even seem you've gone, 'cause all our hearts in big and small ways will keep the love that keeps us strong. And friends are friends forever, if the Lord's the Lord of them. And a friend will not say never, 'cause the welcome will not end. Though it's hard to let you go, in the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live as friends. With the faith and love God's given, springing from the hope we know, we will pray the joy you live in is the strength that now you show. But we'll keep you close as always. It won't even seem you've gone, 'cause our hearts in big and small ways will keep the love that keeps us strong. And friends are friends forever, if the Lord's the Lord of them. And a friend will not say never, 'cause the welcome will not end. Though it's hard to let you go, in the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live as friends. And friends are friends forever, if the Lord's the Lord of them. And a friend will not say never, 'cause the welcome will not end. Though it's hard to let you go, in the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live as friends.
Hi, everybody. Dr. Skinner here. Hey, thanks for being with us today to worship, to celebrate together. Even though it's virtual, digital, it's still spiritual. It's still our BSM community. So thank you. Our next segment here is some special awards that we do as a tradition at BSM every year at about this time at the end of the year. Faculty of the Year, Staff of the Year, Apple Polisher, and Parents' Choice Award. So I'll start off with Faculty of the Year Award. All right, so each year the faculty and staff nominate a colleague to receive the Faculty of the Year Award. We received a great number of nominations, so much so that I want to take just a moment to recognize all of our teachers, our outstanding faculty. Especially this year, our teachers have stepped up to the challenge of being online, being away from our students physically, but still able to stay connected and to continue to love and support our students. So thank you to all of our teachers. All right, so on to the award. Out of the nominations we received this year, one person's name appeared so often. So here are some of the reasons why this person was nominated. One of the most outstanding teachers we have ever had. Committed to teaching and bringing out the best in students. She has been a positive, uplifting, amazing role model to all of us. Students learn so much from her, and what they learn sticks with them for life. All right, so a few more clues. This teacher has been with BSM for over 20 years. She was initially hired to teach French, but the English department stole her away, and there she remained. She has coached our stellar, award-winning speech team, has directed many one-act competition plays, and she's been a BSM parent since 1999 when her oldest son, Matt, started in our junior high. So I'm sure you've guessed it, our Faculty of the Year, Mrs. Brew. Congratulations, Mrs. Brew. And I tell you, we really congratulate her. We are going to miss her. You might not know this, but Mrs. Brew is retiring this year. Well deserved. We'll miss you, but remember, once a red knight, always a red knight.
Extreme challenges tend to bring out the best in people and also the worst, sometimes in the very same day. There's no question during the past 2 months, many at BSM have risen beyond expectations, creating exceptional positive influences across the school. One individual in particular has elevated everyone's game. This person is incredibly talented and is certainly a thought leader. Instructional design, leading edge technology, and the future of education are all areas of professional expertise associated with this individual. Furthermore, the adaptability, constant learning, and unique perspectives offered in support of colleagues, students, and families has been on display so clearly this year. Here are a few words from colleagues to illustrate these points. Without this person, BSM would not have been successful with EOS learning the later part of quarter three and all of quarter four. This individual has worked tirelessly to make everyone else's job easier. BSM is a known leader in the Twin Cities for educating students for the future, but this person helped us to shine brighter than ever before during these unprecedented challenges of distance teaching and learning. Simply put, according to another colleague, dude has carried us through all this craziness. Please join me in virtually congratulating this year's Staff Person of the Year, Dr. Steve Polin.
Hi, I'm Kristen Hansberry, Vice President of the Parent Association. I am honored to be here this year to help present the Parents' Choice Award. The Parents' Choice Award provides an opportunity for parents to honor a faculty, staff, or administrator who has had an impact on BSM students. Starting in the fall and throughout the year, the Parent Association solicits nominations from parents. All comments that are submitted throughout the year will be forwarded to the people that are nominated. The winner of the Parents' Choice Award will receive a $1,000 donation to the Gift of the Magi Scholarship Fund in their name and a little something for themselves, too. On behalf of the Parent Association, and especially this year, we want to thank and honor all faculty, staff, and administrators for the tremendous job they do to support our BSM students and community. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ufris Argenta, and I'm the president of the BSM Parent Association. Before I announce the winner of this year's Parents' Choice Award, I want to take a moment to acknowledge the extra time, care, and effort put into planning classes this year by all teachers and staff at Benilde-St. Margaret's. On behalf of BSM parents, I thank you all for your flexibility and creativity this year, and for working to make sure our students have felt loved and supported through these very unusual times. I would also like to acknowledge the work put in by Parent Association board members this year to help recognize our teachers. In particular, Lisa Elson-Bast and Kristen Smart for coordinating Parents' Choice nominations and for tabulating the winner of this year's award. And now, here are some of the comments made about this year's Parents' Choice winner. This person engages the children and makes them excited to go to class. Even during online school, my student and his classmates are always excited to check in to this class. This teacher is warm, and it is evident that she loves to teach. This person is a great teacher that demands a high level of accountability from her students. This teacher always comes to school with a smile and greets the students and parents with a smile too. She is motivated, a hard worker, has realistic expectations, but pushes her students to do their best. She has high energy, and you can tell she loves her job. She has embraced online classes wonderfully, considering she has told parents in the past she does not love everything about technology. Finally, it was mentioned by several parents in their nominations that material that students have learned in this teacher's class has been referenced by them years after being in her class. On behalf of the Parent Association, I am pleased to announce this year's winner of the Parents' Choice Award. May I have the envelope, please? And the winner is Yvonne Zahidi.
In the 1994-95 school year, the National Honor Society created an award that recognizes a faculty or staff member from the Benilde-St. Margaret's community who has been instrumental in the development and achievement of its students. The Apple Polisher Award is a special honor that acknowledges an exceptional person who demonstrates outstanding service and dedication to students. The award is all the more special because its recipients are nominated and selected by the students themselves. For the sake of fairness, the last five Apple Polisher Award winners are not eligible. On behalf of the members of the National Honor Society and all the students at BSM, we would like to present a small token of appreciation to the Apple Polisher Award recipient. In the words of students themselves, this teacher always brings the right amount of energy to the classroom. Whenever you are feeling down, chances are this teacher can switch that around for you. Is great at teaching and is super helpful to trying to make kids understand what they are struggling with. He is also super friendly and outgoing, which makes the learning environment much more enjoyable. Is a teacher that pushes you in the best way, even when it's online. He cares and is willing to help anyone and teaches things effectively so that most, if not everyone, can easily transition into daily work, and is very easy to approach and great at helping those who struggle. He puts all his time into making sure that we feel comfortable in class and like we can achieve anything. Not to mention, he is very funny. Please join me in congratulating this year's recipient of the Apple Polisher Award, Mr. John Gross.
First, my congratulations go out to all of you who are honored today. You've made an important and memorable impact on so many this year. And second, I'm grateful for all that have had to rethink how we go about keeping our community connected over the course of this year. Today, we were able to participate in our closing school mass. We're also able to celebrate the contributions of many people because there are so many committed to making this school a special place. Remember, whether we are in our school building or whether we are in our homes, we are Benilde-St. Margaret's.